Today we're going to start off with chapter number 21, which is consumer theory. For this particular chapter, I'm going to make use of my handouts, which have already been emailed to you. Previously, I explained to you that whatever contents that we study in economics or whatever topics that we study in economics, they can be divided into three components. So in the first component, we study about individual behavior. In the second component, we study about how markets work. And in the third component, we study about how economy as a whole works. So, so far, whatever chapters that we have studied, they fall under the second component, that is how individuals interact with one another or how markets operate. If you remember, we have covered the chapter on supply and demand and elasticity. Both these chapters, they fall under the second component of economics. So here we started in those chapters, we studied about how the forces of supply and demand work in the marketplace. And as a result, how is price and output level determined in the market? Now we're going to switch to the first component of economics, where we study about individual behavior. And the individuals that we're going to concentrate in this particular chapter are the consumers. So we are basically going to zoom into a typical consumer, and we're going to try to, study his behavior. So consumer theory, it describes the consumer behavior. It's a theory which pertains to consumer behavior. It explains how consumers make their consumption decisions. Now, it's pretty straightforward to visualize that consumers, they face a choice between multiple goods and services, and they end up choosing only one of those goods and services. So how do consumers decide that they need to choose a particular combination of goods and services and not the others? They're basically using two criteria to make their decision. The first criteria that they're using is that the commodity that they end up buying, it should fall within their budget. And the second criteria that they are using is that that particular bundle or that particular combination of goods and services should be the most preferred combination of goods and services out of the affordable bundles which are available out there. So two things are, agar consumer ke paas unginat bundles hain to choose from, he will end up picking or choosing a bundle which is affordable, theek hai, jo wo khareed bhi sake, and secondly, it should be the most preferred bundle out of the affordable bundles. So ye simple idea hai which is going to be developed in this particular chapter, and the simple idea, it actually comprises the consumer theory, ki consumers make their decision based on their budget and their choices or their preferences. So consumer theory ko hum jo hai na do parts mein develop karenge. So in the first component, we're going to develop the consumer's budget constraint, or we're going to model the consumer's budget constraint, that is what the consumer can afford. A budget constraint, it basically shows a various combination of goods that consumers can afford given his or her income and prices of goods. So once we're able to derive this budget line or this budget constraint, it will help us to identify the combination of goods and services which a consumer can afford and the combinations that he cannot afford. So now we're going to derive this budget line or construct this budget line with the help of a simple example here. But before I go over this example, you need to be familiar with a few notations. So the first notation that you need to be familiar with is that of a consumption bundle. Consumption model hoti kya hai? It's simply a basket which contains different combinations of goods and services. So here you can see that consumption bundle, it is equal to is X1, which is actually the quantity of commodity 1, X2 is the quantity of commodity 2, X3 is the quantity of commodity 3, and so on. For simplicity, we will assume that the consumer only has to choose between two commodities, which we have identified to be pizza and Pepsi. So we can think of pizza as commodity one. So pizza is our commodity one, and Pepsi is our commodity two or X2. So on your handouts, I've also written down the definition of consumption bundle. It's a combination of two goods and services. For example, 40 pizzas and 300 Pepsi. And these combinations can be infinite. You can either consume one pizza, two Pepsi, 40 pizzas, 300 Pepsi, 400 pizzas, 700 Pepsis, and the list goes on. So we need to identify that out of all of these, you know, infinite bundles, which are the bundles which are affordable to our consumer. In order to determine affordability, you also need to know the consumer's income, which we have assumed to be $1,000. The prices of the two commodities is as follows. So pizza costs $10 and Pepsi costs $2. Now, a few more notations that you should be familiar with is that M stands for income. So in this particular example, M is going to be $1,000. The price of commodity one, for us, commodity one was pizza. So the price of commodity one is $10. The price of commodity two is $2 here. X1 is the amount of pizza and X2 is the amount of Pepsi. Now let's consider the first scenario here. So the first scenario is as follows. So let's suppose that the consumer spends all of his income on pizza. So how many pizzas does he buy? So here I want you to identify the consumption bundle that the consumer is consuming. So I'll call this consumption bundle A, and the consumption bundle A, as you see, that it will contain a certain combination of pizzas and Pepsi. So pizza, if you're spending all your money on pizza, and if you're spending $1,000 on pizza, the maximum pizzas that you should be able to consume is going to be 100. And the quantity of Pepsi in this particular scenario is going to be 0. So this is my consumption bundle A here, which comprises of 100 pizzas and 0 Pepsis. Now moving to scenario 2. In scenario 2, we're assuming that the consumer spends all of his income on Pepsi. So how many Pepsi does he buy? So similarly, consumption bundle B comprises of 0 pizzas because we're spending all of our money on commodity 2, which is Pepsi. And we know that Pepsi costs $2. So the maximum amount of Pepsi that the consumer can afford here is going to be 1,000 divided by 2, which is going to be 500. Now moving to scenario C here, or the third scenario. So here, if you can see that, let's suppose that the consumer spends $400 on pizza. So how many pizzas and Pepsi does he buy? So here we're making the simplifying assumption that he's spending $400 on pizza, and the remaining $600 are going to be spent on Pepsi. So you can easily figure it out that my consumption bundle C will comprise of 40 pizzas, and with the remaining $600, the maximum Pepsi that I can consume is going to be 300. So here I've identified three consumption bundles based on three different scenarios. And now what I want you to do is, I want you to plot these three consumption bundles on this graph here. So when you do that, you can construct the consumer's budget constraint or the budget line. So the way we construct the budget line is that on the x-axis, we take commodity one. And on the y-axis, we take commodity 2. So in this particular case, I've taken X1, which is pizza, on the x-axis, and Pepsi, which is commodity 2, on the y-axis. Now, the commodities have been chosen arbitrarily. You could have chosen pizza to be on the y-axis, and you could have chosen Pepsi to be commodity 1. Hence, you could have taken it on the x-axis. So that doesn't matter. You're free to identify. Choose what is going to be commodity one and what is going to be commodity two in a particular scenario. Okay. Now, coming back to plotting now, let me just switch to this mode here. Okay, now consumption bundle A, if you remember, here we were spending all of our money on commodity one, which is pizza. So consumption bundle A is going to be this point here. Consumption bundle B, In the second scenario, if you remember, we were spending all our money on Pepsi. So the maximum amount of Pepsi that we can consume was 500. Okay, so this is going to be consumption bundle B is going to be over here. And consumption bundle C contained 40 pizzas and 300 Pepsi. So 40, 300, this is going to be my consumption bundle C. So here I've only drawn three consumption bundles, but joining these three points together will give me the consumer's budget constraint. So the red line that you see here, this is actually the consumer's budget constraint. Now, you can only see three consumption bundles on this line, but if you look closely, there are infinite consumption bundles on this particular line. And you can verify that all of these consumption bundles will completely exhaust the consumer income, which is $500, which is $1,000. Yeah, so you can verify that you can think of this consumption bundle here. This will be another consumption bundle. You can call it D. So 20 pizzas and it comprises of 400 Pepsi. So this combination of the two commodities will cost $1,000. Again, if you consider this combination, it will also cost $1,000. So jitne bhi consumption bundles, a budget line basically comprises of the points on the budget constraint, it comprises of different consumption bundles. And one common thing about all these consumption bundles is that they completely exhaust the consumer income, which is $1,000 in this particular case. So if I have to write down the equation of this budget line, that equation is going to be this. So the equation is as follows. It's P1 times Q1. If I can highlight it. Okay. All right, so you can see from the handouts here that the budget line here is going to be, the equation of the budget line is the price of commodity times time quantity of commodity one plus P2 times the quantity of commodity two is equal to is your total income. You can verify that in this particular example, the prices were fixed and the income was fixed. So this budget line basically contains different combinations of X1 and X2, which completely exhaust the consumer income. Now, given this budget line, you can also work out that the vertical axis, at the vertical axis, the consumer is consuming 0 units of commodity 1, and you can solve for X2 then. So if you plug 0 in this equation here and solve for X2, you're going to get M divided by P2. So in simple words, if the consumer is spending all of his income on commodity 2, the maximum amount of commodity 2 that he can consume is going to be M divided by P2. Similarly, if the consumer is spending all of his money on commodity 1, that is, if X2 is equal to 0, just plug 0 in this equation and solve for X1, you will get M divided by P2. And the slope of the budget line traces out to be minus P1 divided by P2. If you look closely, this equation is actually an equation. An equation of a straight line. So the slope of this equation is going to be minus P1 divided by P2. So just to summarize what we have derived so far, this budget line, it identifies all the consumption bundles which completely exhaust the consumer income of $1,000. Now, all the consumption bundles that lie below this budget line, this area that you see here that I've shaded, this is going to comprise of all the consumption bundle which costs less than $1,000. You can verify that as well. So if you take this particular consumption bundle, which contains 20 units of commodity one and 200 units of commodity two, you can see that the expenditure on this consumption bundle is going to be less than $1,000. Similarly, जितनी भी consumption bundles that lie above the budget line, ठीक है, these consumption bundles will cost the consumer more than $1,000, and you can verify, just take any consumption bundle, and you can see for yourself that this consumption bundle is going to cost the consumer more than $1,000. So in short, the budget line, it contains all the consumption bundles which are affordable. The budget line, it contains all the consumption on the budget line and below the budget line are all the consumption bundles which are affordable, and above the consumption bundle or above the budget constraint are all the consumption bundles which are beyond the budget of the consumer. Okay. So I'll just stop at this point and continue in the next lecture. Okay, this is part two of consumer theory. In the last class, मैंने आपको explain किया था कि consumer theory को हम दो parts में develop करेंगे. In the first part, we're going to model the consumer's budget constraint. In other words, we're going to model or identify all the consumption bundles which the consumer can afford. And in the second part, we're going to develop the consumer's preferences. We're going to model the consumer's likes and dislikes. ये दोनों चीजें मिलके ही हमें it will allow us to identify the best consumption bundle for the consumer. और वो best consumption bundle जो है वो affordable भी होगी और out of the affordable bundles consumer को सबसे ज़्यादा पसंद भी होगी. पिछले पार्ट में हमने एक सिंपल एग्जांपल के थ्रू बजट लाइन या बजट कंस्ट्रेंट कंस्ट्रक्ट करना सीखी थी. इफ यू रिमेंबर, दिस इज द बजट लाइन दैट वी वर एबल टू कंस्ट्रक्ट. द इक्वेशन ऑफ द बजट लाइन इज एज फॉलोज. Okay, this is the equation of the budget line. It's price of commodity one times quantity of commodity one plus P2 times X2 is equal to is M. Now, if you want to construct the budget line, you always take commodity one on the X-axis and you take commodity two on the Y-axis. Agar aap isko demand curve se compare karein, remember in the case of demand curve, we take commodity on the X-axis and price of that commodity on the Y-axis. Although budget line or budget constraint is also downward sloping, lekin this thing is different. Ye jo aapko curve nazar aa raha hai na, it is different than the demand curve. Demand curve shows you the relationship between quantity of the product and price of the product, whereas here we are drawing or we are taking commodity one and commodity two on the x-axis. Aur jo line ye ban rahi hai, ye jo aapko line nazar aa rahi hai, it basically contains infinite consumption bundles. Okay, har point on this budget line, it is a consumption bundle which contains different combinations of commodity one and commodity two. Ek khas baat ya ek common baat in sare consumption bundles ke darmiyan ye hai ki all of these consumption bundles, whether they are A, B or C or any point on this budget line, they will completely exhaust the consumer income, which in this example is denoted by M. So agar hum general equation ki baat kare budget line ki, to wo aapke samne hai yahan. Aur is particular example ki agar hawale se baat ki jaye, to aapko yaad hai ki is example mein price of commodity one was $10. ठीक है, commodity one हमने पिज़्ज़ा ली है, so it's going to be 10 times X1 plus price of commodity two, which is Pepsi, was $2, so it's going to be 2 times X2, and income is equal to is $1,000. So for this particular example, my जो ये general equation है ना budget line की, it transforms to this here. इस जनरल इक्वेशन से आपको बहुत क्लियरली नजर आ रहा है कि अगर सारी इनकम कमोडिटी वन पे खर्च कर दी जाए, व्हिच इज अ कंजम्पशन बंडल सच एज बी, द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ कमोडिटी टू दैट यू कैन कंज्यूम इज गोइंग टू बी एम डिवाइडेड बाय पी टू. ठीक है, एम अगर आप प्लग इन कर लें वैल्यू, दिस इज गोइंग टू बी 1000 डिवाइडेड बाय प्राइस ऑफ कमोडिटी टू जो है, दैट इज इन दिस केस $2, सो दिस विल गिव मी $500. अच्छा, जो वर्टिकल एक्सिस है ना, ये मैं थोड़ा सा करेक्ट कर रही हूँ अपने आप को, वर्टिकल एक्सिस रिप्रेजेंट्स दिस कंजम्पशन बंडल ए, है योर स्पेंडिंग ऑल योर मनी और ऑल ऑफ योर इनकम ऑन कमोडिटी टू, वेयर एज द हॉरिजॉन्टल इंटरसेप्ट विच इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय दिस कंजम्पशन बंडल बी, इट रिप्रेजेंट्स द फैक्ट दैट यू आर स्पेंडिंग ऑल ऑफ योर इनकम ऑन कमोडिटी वन. So this, if you plug in the values here, n ki value 1000 hai divided by 10, this is going to give me 100. And this is exactly what we see on this x-axis here. The slope of the budget line is negative P1 over P2. Achha, let's just elaborate on this budget line a little further. I'm going to move to the second page here. Achha ji. अगर आप रिकॉल करें इक्वेशन ऑफ अ स्ट्रेट लाइन, आपने ये स्कूल में पढ़ा होगा कि द जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ द स्ट्रेट लाइन इज एज फॉलोज, ये जो आपको ब्लू में नजर आ रही है, इट्स वाई इज इक्वल टू इज एम एक्स प्लस सी. ठीक है, सो वाई इज बेसिकली योर डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, एक्स इज योर इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, एम जो है इस जनरल इक्वेशन में वॉज द स्लोप ऑफ द बजट लाइन एंड सी वॉज द वर्टिकल इंटरसेप्ट. So, okay, this is the equation. This is a general equation of a straight line. Hamari budget line bhi jo hai na, it is a straight line. So the equation of the budget line is as follows. Isko agar aap rearrange kar le is equation ko, so it matches the general equation. I'm just rearranging this equation so that it matches the general equation. In order to do that, I'm going to isolate x2. Remember, in this particular example, x2 जो है ना, it's on the y-axis, x1 is on the x-axis. So, इस particular example में x1 is actually the product on the x-axis and x2 is basically y. तो मैंने इस हमारी जो budget line है, इसको मैंने जो है ना, I want to arrange it in a similar manner as this general equation that I see here. For this, I need to do simple rearrangement. I'm going to isolate x2 on the left-hand side of the equation and throw all the terms on the right-hand side of the equation. When you do that, this is what you get. ये मैंने आपके convenience के लिए ये कर भी दिया है यहाँ. अच्छा, अब try to match this with this general equation here. अच्छा जी, ये जो आपको चीज नजर आ रही है, okay, the term that you see over here, m divided by p2, ye jo hai na, this corresponds to c here. Theek hai? This is my vertical intercept. Aur jo cheez x1 ke saath lagi hui hai, theek hai? Jo x1 ke saath aapko cheez attached nazar aa rahi hai, that's minus p1 over p2. This is actually my m, which is the slope of the budget line. तो इसीलिए हम कह रहे हैं कि द स्लोप ऑफ द बजट लाइन इज माइनस p1 ओवर p2. अगर आपको याद हो स्लोप की इंटरप्रिटेशन क्या होती है, द इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द स्लोप इज दैट इफ कमोडिटी 1 इंक्रीजेस बाय 1 यूनिट, यू विल हैव टू डिक्रीज कमोडिटी 2 बाय माइनस p1 डिवाइडेड बाय p2 यूनिट्स. आपको याद है कि पिज्जा की प्राइस $10 है, पेप्सी की प्राइस $2 है. सो इफ आई वॉन्ट टू इंक्रीज द कंजम्पशन ऑफ पिज्जा बाय 1 यूनिट, दैट मीन्स आई हैव टू फ्री अप $10. और ये $10 किस तरह फ्री अप होंगे, इफ आई गिव अप 5 यूनिट्स ऑफ पेप्सी. ठीक है, आपको याद है कि p1 इज 10 divided by 2, this is also equal to is minus 5. So interpretation of the slope bahut important hai yahan samajhna. Aur interpretation kya hai ki agar main pizza ko ya commodity 1 ko 1 unit se increase karti hu, to mujhe Pepsi ki consumption ko minus p1 divided by p2 unit se kam karne padenge. Aur ye, this should not come as a surprise to you that why is the budget line downward sloping. It should be downward sloping. अभी तो हमने कहा कि इस budget line पे जितनी भी consumption bundles हैं, they cost exactly $1,000. They completely exhaust my income. तो अगर मैं इस point से, okay, so if I want to move from this particular point on the budget line to this point on the budget line, I need to give up, theek hai, main dollars free karungi. If I have to, I will give up commodity two, which is going to free up dollars, which will free up money, which will allow me to increase the consumption of commodity one. Okay, so just to summarize, budget line will always be downward sloping. If you look at this equation one more time, this thing is going to become clear to you. Ki dekhe, agar aap commodity one ko agar main increase karna chah rahi hun, okay? So agar main commodity one ko increase karna chah rahi hun, so definitely commodity two ko mujhe decrease karna padega in order to maintain this identity. Prices fixed hai, M fixed hai. Commodity one ko agar main increase karna chahti hun, commodity two mujhe decrease karni padegi. Therefore, the slope of the budget line will always be negative. And to be more precise, the slope of the budget line is equal to as this term here that you see, which is minus P1 divided by P2. If you go over your handouts, this is a very important, explanation of the slope of the budget line. The slope of the budget line equals the relative price of two goods, that is, its price of one good divided by price of the other good. So here we are saying that the slope is equal to is P1 divided by P2. Now, this is something that I really want to emphasize. The slope measures the rate at which the consumer can actually trade one good for another. ठीक है, ये जो actually का लफ्ज है ना, इस पे इसको आप जरा अब याद रखिएगा. अगर मैंने पिज्जा एक यूनिट से इंक्रीज करना है, आई विल हैव टू गिव अप 5 यूनिट्स ऑफ पेप्सी, बिकॉज बाय डूइंग सो दैट इज गोइंग टू फ्री अप $10 जो कि मैं इस्तेमाल कर सकती हूँ टू बाय वन एडिशनल यूनिट ऑफ पिज्जा है. राइट, सो नाउ लेट्स डू अ सिंपल एग्जाम्पल. हमने पिछले पार्ट में ये ओरिजिनल बजट लाइन जो है डिराइव कर ली थी. नाउ वंस the equation of the budget line is clear to you, you can now play along with whether you want to play around with any change in scenario now. So let's do the small exercise. Now you have to show me what happens to the budget line if income falls by $800. Main keh rahi hu ki prices of the two commodities are not changing, it's only that income that has reduced from 1000 to $800. So as a result, meri budget line pe kya farak padega? Aap equation aapke saamne hai, P1, this is the equation of the budget line if you remember. Main keh rahi hu ki prices same hai. So dekhe, agar prices same hai, to that means slope is not going to change. ठीक है, prices mein tabdili to nahi aayi, to slope to change nahi hoga. Minus P1 over P2 will remain 5. लेकिन द वर्टिकल एंड द हॉरिजॉन्टल इंटरसेप्ट्स विल चेंज. आई टोल्ड यू दैट द इक्वेशन ऑफ द वर्टिकल इंटरसेप्ट इज m डिवाइडेड बाय p2. अब m इज नो लॉन्गर 1000, इट्स नाउ 800. सो इट्स नाउ गोइंग टू बी 800 डिवाइडेड बाय 2, व्हिच गिव्स मी 400. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी ओके, सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी the new vertical intercept. And what will be the new horizontal intercept? It's now going to be 800 divided by 10. So it's going to be 80 here. Since a budget line is always a straight line, so mujhe jo hai na, if I know two points of a straight line, I can draw the entire line or the entire budget line. So you can see that the new budget line is represented by this red line jo ki maine abhi banayi hai. So agar main aapse poochun ki is the consumer better off or worse off, so aapka answer ye hona chahiye that the consumer is now worse off. The reason why that is the case is ki dekhe, ye wali jo bundles hain, ye jitni bhi consumption bundles jo ki is strip mein lie kar rahi hain, jo main abhi shade kar rahi hu, ये पहले अफोर्डेबल थी, बट नाउ दे हैव बिकम अनअफोर्डेबल. सो द कंज्यूमर हैज बिकम वर्स ऑफ. consumer can only now afford the consumption bundles which lie on this red line and the consumption bundles which are below this red line. So as a result, we are making the consumer worse off. Now, similarly, let's work out what will happen if the price of Pepsi rises. So let me just rub off. I'll just use the eraser here. Let me just rub off what I have made so far. Sure. Okay. This budget line could be, if I can rub this off. Oh, no. Anyways, hum kya keh rahe hain ki, let's suppose income wahi $1,000 hai. Or the price of Pepsi, it rises to $4. Okay. So as a result, what will happen to my budget line? Price of Pepsi increases. Achal. Isko phir se aap jo hai na apne saamne le aaye, ye jo general equations hain. Main keh rahi hu ki commodity, ab work out what will happen to the horizontal intercept. Income wahi $1,000 hai. So that doesn't change. Price of commodity one is again $10. Pizza ki price to nahi badhi na. So yani horizontal intercept will remain the same. On the other hand, let's see what happens to the vertical intercept. M is again $1,000, but now price has actually increased to $4. Theek hai? So pehle jo price aapki jo thi na, that was $2, and now it has increased to $4. So the new vertical intercept is going to be 1,000 divided by 4, which is 250 now. Okay. So coming back to this grid here. So main keh rahi hu ke horizontal price, agar commodity 2 ki tabdeel ho rahi hai, to commodity 1 ka horizontal intercept is not going to change, but commodity 2 ka jo vertical intercept hai na, now it is going to decrease to 250, which is going to be somewhere over here. Let's just join these two new points together. So this red line jo abhi maine banayi hai, this is going to be the new budget line. So you can see for yourself ki budget line has actually swinged inwards. So ek general observation agar main aapse share karun to wo ye hai ki income ke kam zyada hone se, you can work out that the budget line is going to shift inwards or outwards. Income agar kam ho rahi hai to budget line andar ki taraf shift karegi, agar income badh rahi hai to income to budget line bahar ki taraf shift karegi. So agar you can work out the case, let's suppose that the income increases to $1,200. So us case mein, you can work out that the new budget line is going to be this now. It's going to be a parallel shift outwards. So now the consumer is being made better off. Wajah? Ye wali jo consumption bundle hai, jo ke is trip mein lai kar rahi hai, ye pehle unaffordable thi, but now because of increase in income, it has become affordable. So let's just summarize what I've just said so far. Income, agar increase ho rahi hai, to budget line is going to shift outwards in a parallel manner. If income is decreasing, the budget line is going to shift inwards in a parallel manner. However, if price of the commodity changes, that will result in, if the price of commodity 2 is decreasing, that will result, when the price of commodity 2 is increasing, the budget line is going to swing inwards. Similarly, when the price of commodity 2 is decreasing, you can work out that the budget line is going to swing outwards. And in case the price of commodity 1 decrease ho rahi hai, to wahi cheez hogi, budget line, agar price of commodity 1 decrease ho rahi hai, budget line is going to swing outwards. Or agar consumption or the price of commodity 1 decreases, the budget line is going to swing inwards. Main aapko multiple scenarios yahan de sakti hu. For example, I can ask you what happens if the prices double and the income also double. You should be able to work this out. देखें अगर prices double हो रही हैं और income भी double हो रही है, यानी देखें income increases, यानी m increases by 2, you just mind my free hand, price is also doubling. So देखें ये 2 and 2 cancels out, that means the vertical intercept remains the same. Similarly, horizontal intercept को देख सकते हैं कि अगर m increases by 2, peak 1 is also being multiplied by 2, 2 and 2 cancels out, vertical intercept remains the same. Slope के हवाले से अगर बात करें तो अगर P1 increases by 2, P2 is also doubling, तो again 2 and 2 cancels out and the slope remains the same. So हमने conclude किया कि अगर prices double and income also double simultaneously, budget line will remain unchanged. So इस तरह मैं आपको multiple scenarios दे सकती हूँ, and in those particular scenarios you will have to work out what will happen to the budget line if income changes, price changes, or both changes. So I now hope you should be able to do it on your own. बस आपको general logic पता होना चाहिए. You need to know the equation of the budget line. Then I think if you're comfortable with that, you should be able to work what is going to happen to the budget line if income changes or when price changes. So I'll just stop this lecture at this point.